We got a couple of Reverend Jackson sound bites. Was on with Megyn Kelly this afternoon on Fox. She said, I want to ask you for your response to that scene. We just showed it with a lawmaker saying, let us do our jobs. This is America. The Republicans there are growing increasingly frustrated at what they perceive as an inability to just go and vote.
These are not so much angry demonstrations. They are hurt and desperate. These workers here who have lost their jobs, their homes are in foreclosure.
No.
They can't pay student loan debt.
No.
They're fighting back for the most basic of democratic rights. And so they're going to escalate these protests. You're either going to have collective bargaining through a vehicle called collective bargaining, or you're going to have it through the streets. But people here are going to fight back because they think their cause is moral. And they have no place else to go.
He doesn't know what he's talking about. I think, you know, Jesse Jackson is a Ken doll. There's a little string in his back with a little ring, and you pull it, and out comes standardized answer number one. And you pull it again, here comes standardized answer number two. We're not talking about people who have lost their jobs. Quite the contrary. We're not talking about people who have lost their homes in foreclosure, Reverend Jackson. Public sector union people have not, for the most part, experienced that precisely because they were the beneficiaries of the stimulus. $800 billion, $700 million of it went to Wisconsin. Little less than 10% of the stimulus went to Wisconsin. $600 million that Wisconsin got went to public sector unions. So while during the recession, private sector people were losing their jobs and were losing their homes to foreclosure, the Obama administration saw to it that that would not happen to public sector union people. And again, folks, I hate to be repetitive. I sometimes feel like I'm cheating you if every utterance is not something new that you haven't heard before, but really, it's not complicated. The whole purpose of that stimulus, we were lied to. Virtually every syllable in sales pitch was a lie. The purpose of the stimulus was not shovel-ready jobs. It wasn't schools and roads and bridges. It wasn't any of that. It wasn't to boost private sector employment. It was strictly a slush fund to make sure that employees who pay union dues would continue to have jobs so that Democrats would get their campaign donations. That's all it was. There's nothing more to it than that. Everything else was a fraud. Everything else was a hoax. We were lied to about it. Explain again, Mr. Limbaugh, how this works, because I think it's outrageous that you are making these claims. Very simple. Because I think this is important to understand. One of the first things the regime does when they assume office is care about the recession. It's Bush's fault. Look at what we've inherited. And I'm not going to put up with it. I care about the people. I'm Barack Obama. I'm going to make sure people get back to work. The way to do this is to spend and spend. We got shovel-ready jobs. We're going to make sure private sector employment grows. 3 to 4 million jobs. I need nearly $800 billion. The Republicans, who are they to say no? They just got shellacked in the last election. Everybody is trying to get in on the action. Obama's the greatest president we've ever had. He's the first black president, therefore historic, so nobody dares utter a word of criticism about his policies, except for me, El Rushbo, who at that time was hoping for failure on the part of Obama. So what happens? Republicans don't object. Some did. I mean, it actually, there was some objection to this, but it still passed. Easily, and everybody celebrated. And then we came to find out, as the months unfolded, where the money went. And it was going to states. It went to the states ostensibly to make sure that they were able to balance their budgets. And More importantly, to keep state workers on the payroll because they are union workers. Now, we know that 90% of the collected dues of state public sector union workers go to the Democrat Party. Well, if you're in a recession and people are losing their jobs, but you don't want to lose your money, you can't just go to Congress and say, you know what, I'm Barack Obama, I'm president, I want $800 billion here for Democrat campaign war chests. Even if they would have gotten it, you just don't go get it. You don't want people to think that's what you're doing. So you tell people it's for them and their jobs and their roads and bridges and their schools. Then you find out that all it was money to make sure the recession did not claim the jobs of public sector union employees. Pure and simple. And it's not because the regime so much cares about them personally. It's because those people, when they work, continually replenish Democrat campaign war chests. So then, a couple of weeks ago, we found out what the numbers in Wisconsin were. $700 million of stimulus. There was $787 billion. That's a lot. It's almost $1 trillion. A little bit less than 10%. When there's 50 states, a little bit less than 10% goes to Wisconsin. It's a battleground state. Around $700 million. $600 million of the $700 million in stimulus money sent to Wisconsin went to public sector union employees. Salaries, jobs, raises, pension plans, whatever it was, healthcare plans. No roads, no bridges, no private sector jobs, not any of that. That's why this abject panic. That's why the left is so upset here. The gravy train, the money laundering express, if you will. The apple cart's going to be upset here. So when Jesse Jackson shows up with that little string coming out of his back, a little white loop, and you pull it, here comes statement one and statement two. He doesn't know what he's talking about. This is not about people who lost their homes, just the opposite. Not about people who have lost their jobs. He wasn't through, by the way. People are going to fight back because they think their cause is moral and they have no place to go. And then he continued to speak to Megyn Kelly.
These maneuvers inciting more anger and more pain and more fear. I hope people govern by deliberation and reconciliation and not by ramrodding politics. It's going to create a rebellion, so now it's revolt and recall. You see children leaving school because they feel hurt with the K-12 cut. Teachers revolting because they feel their jobs are being lost. Home foreclosures with no place to go. Too few got too much. Too many are getting poorer and the middle class is sinking. People here need a better deal. And when you take away collective bargaining, you take away content. That's why you can get away with cuts for education, and you can try to change the standards for Medicare and K-12 education. You must resolve this issue with some shared pain.
What? What did he say? Too few got too much. People are getting poor. The middle class is sinking. The people will need a better deal. Take away collective bargaining and content. That's how you can get away with cuts in education and try to change the standards for Medicare and K-12 education. What? Where does this guy live? I mean, every time something like this happens anywhere, within hours he's there. Does he have a unit manager? Hey, Jesse, hey, there's the first flying in Wisconsin. Be at the airport here. Blah, blah, the plane's going here. You get off there. We got a driver to pick you up, and you go down there. Here's the rhyme for today. The rhyme for today is revolt and recall. I'm a logistics guy. How does this happen? Who's paying for him to be there? You know, he's not. Or could I be wrong about that, Mr. Snurdly? Could he be paying? No. All right. Okay. This one. So that Jesse Jackson unleashed.